In part two of our lesson on trigonometric functions of acute angles, we're going to study the cofunction identities. Now, in the previous example, in part one, we had right triangle ABC. And now we want to determine what is the relationship between angles A and B. We know in every triangle, we can use the triangle sum theorem. So we know angle A plus angle B plus angle C has to add up to be 180 degrees. Now we know that angle C is equal to 90. So that tells us then that angle A plus angle B has to add up to be 90 degrees, which means they are complementary angles. So the acute angles in a right triangle will always be complementary angles. Now, also using that example, we can see that sine of A was equal to the cosine of angle B. They both were equal to 15 over 17. We find that the secant of angle B has the same value as the cosecant of angle A, and we find that the cotangent of angle A has the same value as the tangent of angle B. Now, what we want to notice is the relationships between these. Sine and cosine are called cofunctions. Secant and cosecant are cofunctions. Cotangent and tangent are cofunctions. So any trig function, for example, sine, its cofunction, you just put co in front of it, cosine. Secant, its cofunction will be cosecant. Tangent, its cofunction will be cotangent. Now we also notice that, as we said earlier, A and B are complementary angles, and we notice we have an A and a B here, so those are complementary angles. We have an A and a B here, so those are complementary angles. And we have an A and a B here, which are complementary angles. So it turns out that cofunctions of complementary angles always end up being equal to each other. So from that, we can develop what are called the cofunction identities. So given each trig function, we just name the cofunction of the complementary angle, and it will be equal to it. So here we have sine theta, so we know its cofunction will be cosine, and its complementary angle will be 90 degrees minus theta. For cosine theta, its cofunction is sine, and the complementary angle will be 90 degrees minus theta. For tangent theta, the cofunction will be cotangent, and the complementary angle, once again, 90 degrees minus theta. For cotangent, the cofunction is tangent, complementary angle, 90 degrees minus theta. For secant, the cofunction is cosecant, and the complementary angle, 90 minus theta. And finally, for cosecant, the cofunction will be secant, and the complementary angle is 90 degrees minus theta. You're going to need to memorize these identities because you will use them many, many times throughout the semester. In this next example, we have to write each function in terms of its cofunction. In this first one, we have sine of 71 degrees. Now, looking at our cofunction identities, we know that sine of theta is equal to cosine of 90 degrees minus theta. So we know this is going to equal cosine of 90 degrees minus 71 degrees, which when we simplify that becomes cosine of 19 degrees. The next one, we have cotangent of a plus 17 degrees. So looking at our cofunction identities, we know that's going to be the tangent of 90 degrees minus the angle, which is a plus 17 degrees. Notice we had to put that in parentheses, so this becomes tangent of 90 degrees minus a minus 17 degrees, which simplifies to be tangent of 73 degrees minus a. Next, we have secant of the quantity 40 minus 3x degrees. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. Now the cofunction of secant is cosecant. We know we have to take 90 degrees minus the angle, and the angle is the quantity 40 minus 3x degrees. So that's going to be the cosecant of 90 degrees minus 40 degrees plus 3x degrees, which is going to simplify to be cosecant of 50 plus 3x degrees. Next up, we have to solve an equation where cosine of the quantity 5 theta minus 10 degrees is equal to sine of the quantity 4 minus 2 theta degrees. And hopefully the first thing you notice is that we have different trig functions on each side, so we're going to have to do something to the equation to get the same trig function on both sides. Now we just learned the cofunction identities, so we can turn cosine into sine or sine into cosine. Either one, it doesn't matter which side, we'll get the same answer. So let's say we've decided we're going to turn sine into cosine. Then the right-hand side is going to become cosine of 90 degrees minus the quantity 4 minus 2 theta degrees, which will simplify to become cosine of 90 degrees minus 4 degrees plus 2 theta, which simplifies to become cosine of 86 degrees plus 2 theta. Now the left-hand side we can bring straight down. It's cosine of 5 theta minus 10 degrees. Now that we have the same trig function on both sides of the equation, we can do the same algebraic function to both sides to undo that. So we know that means we're going to have to take the cosine inverse of each side. So we're going to take the cosine inverse of the cosine of 5 theta minus 10 degrees, which means we're going to have to take the cosine inverse of the right hand side, which is cosine 86 degrees plus 2 theta. Now a function and its inverse function undo each other, so we are left with 5 theta minus 10 degrees. And this degree symbol applies to both of these. We know theta is going to be an angle, so it's okay if you write the degree symbol on the outside of the entire parenthesis, or if you write the degree symbol on the individual elements. Equals, over here, cosine and cosine inverse undo each other, so we're left with 86 degrees plus 2 theta, and now we do the algebra, subtracting 2 theta from both sides, so 5 theta minus 2 theta will be 3 theta. We're going to add 10 degrees to both sides, so 86 plus 10 is 96 degrees. Next, we'll divide both sides by 3 and discover that theta is equal to 32 degrees. So just a quick reminder here, when you're writing a function in terms of its cofunction, it's a pretty easy two-step process. Look at your trig function, and the first thing you're going to do is name the cofunction. The second step is to evaluate the complementary angle and then simplify the angle if necessary.